Good morning, gentlemen and ladies. It's a pleasure to interact with you again on this wonderful medium. Today, I would like to emphasize again on the fact of what hard work is. Hard work is doing important things that one may not feel like doing them mindfully. Or in Hindi, mehnat ki kya paribhasha hai? Zaruri kaam jo aapko aur mujhe kabhi kabhi karne ka dil na kare, usko man laga ke karna, usko mehnat kehte hain. And I would like to recommend a wonderful book authored by Shobha Bondre, a Marathi author. She has authored a book that has been translated into English, and the title is Dhanda, How Gujaratis Do Business. In that book, there's a wonderful story of one Bhimji Bhai Patel, who started off in his life at a very young age working with his father in Saurashtra. His father had some land, they were a marginal farming family. And he worked very, very hard with his father at a very young age. He was unable to attend school, but he realized the importance of education. So what he did was, while helping his father in the farms, he got into the habit of buying newspapers, second-hand or already read newspapers at a cheap price. He was able to fund that because his father would give money sometimes to offer it to the local temple. So he realized that the gods will understand. So instead of putting money in the temple, he would use that money to buy used or read newspapers. And he kept himself abreast. Now, when he was in his early teens, one of his friends, a few years elder to him, was moving from his village towards Surat in Gujarat, where the diamond cutting and polishing industry was starting. So inspired by his friend's example, he took his father's permission and moved on from the village to Surat and really worked very hard to learn the cutting and polishing of diamonds. In the meantime, his younger brothers also were growing older, so they were helping the father. He got married at a relatively young age. His wife also joined him in Surat, and both husband and wife as a couple started working extremely hard. He would keep working in the factories, cutting and polishing diamonds. His wife started cooking. So co-workers of Bhimji Bhai Patel could come and eat food at home with his wife and him, instead of spending that money in a local dhaba or a restaurant. All were happy. They were making money and gradually they were saving it up. Then gradually, one by one, his younger brothers also joined him in Surat. They also learned how to cut and polish diamonds. And with a lot of hard work and effort, they set up a small unit, taking work from other larger plants of cutting and polishing diamonds, wanted to outsource it to a person like Bhimji Bhai Patel. He was very honest and very sincere. And over the years, with the effort of the four brothers working very, very hard, they were able to scale up their operations. A time came when they also became sizable. Then Bhimji Bhai Patel thought of taking it further up, and he thought of actually going to Europe, buying the rough diamonds, bringing them to Surat, cutting and polishing them, and then selling them in the market globally. Now for that, the first step was he had to go to UK, London, to learn the trade of how to procure rough diamonds. So on the first occasion when he went to get a visa at the British consulate in Mumbai, when his turn came, the British visa officer asked him a question in English: Mr. Bhimji Bhai Patel, what is your purpose of going to England? Now, Bhimji Bhai Patel had no idea as to how to understand or speak in English. So he requested the officer, the visa officer, Gujarati ma bolo, or please speak to me in Gujarati. Now, the British gentleman, the officer, he again repeated the question, what is the purpose of you going to Britain? And he again repeated the request, please speak to me in Gujarati. Now, the British officer had the passport of Bhimji Bhai Patel and he stamped rejected. Now he also had trouble reading in English because all he could read was Gujarati. So he saw that there was a lady standing behind the British officer, and she was wearing a sari and she was Indian. So he politely requested the lady to tell him as to what he had done. And she told him that, sorry brother, he has rejected your visa application for Britain. Now Bhimji Bhai Patel thought for a few moments and asked the lady to ask the British officer as to why has he rejected the visa application. And the British officer calmly told the lady to tell him, Bhimji Bhai, that since he cannot converse in English, he is very reluctant to offer him a visa. Now, listening to this, he again thought for a few moments and again requested the lady to ask the British officer a question. And the question was, "Sir, how many Indian languages can you understand and converse in?" Now, when he listened to this question, the British officer, he thought, he smiled, and then he looked at Bhimji Bhai Patel and asked him to give the passport back, which he did. And he crossed that rejected visa and stamped accepted, and then looked at the lady and said, "I've realized my mistake. This gentleman, although he cannot speak in English, but he knows how to communicate." And he realized that he can do very, very well, and he was granted the visa. And over the years, Bhimji Bhai Patel, his brothers, and then their children have done exceedingly well, and they scaled up their operations to global standards. They are now considered to be one of the most prosperous diamond merchant house in the country. So I think examples like Bhimji Bhai Patel and many others that we are able to read or see them on the net or on the television on occasions, I think can be a great way for you and I to inspire ourselves to become a better version of oneself. Now, people like you and I may never be like Bhimji Bhai Patel, we may never be in the diamond business, but yes, reading about them, knowing about them will inspire you and I to work harder and become a better version of self in serving our family and our co-workers and our customers. I wish the viewers to have a fantastic week ahead, and I look forward to being in touch with you from time to time. God bless you and Namaskar.